Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 24 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous two videos, I showed you how you can create overlays from within the Blender program. And in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to use the speed control effect strip to change the speed of your video strip, and I'm going to show you also how to change the speed or pitch of your audio strip and synchronize the two strips together. So let's get started. I have a vlog post here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a segment of this vlog post that we're going to speed up. So what we're going to do is place your line over the beginning point of where you want your first speed up to occur, and you simply make sure you select both strips and Shift K to make a hard cut, and then play the video until you get to a point where you know you want that speed up to end.
And one of the things that I discovered about myself was that for many years I was really playing it a little bit too safe.
Okay, so now I want to make a hard cut here, Shift K, and now we have this short segment that we're going to be playing around with. We're going to change the speed of the video and the audio. So the first thing we want to do is we want to change the speed of the video strip. So let's just select the video strip segment and go down to Add and select Effect Strip and select Speed Control. Okay. Now, I always like to hide the original strip whenever I create a effect strip from it. So hit your H button over it. Right-click on your Speed Control strip and scroll down. And it's very important that you uncheck this option, Stretch to Input Strip Length. Make sure that's turned off. And instead, set the speed factor to 1. Hit Enter. And the multiply speed is going to be what determines if our video is sped up or slowed down. So the multiply speed will take the speed factor and just multiply it. So 1 times 1 equals 1. It will play it at the regular speed. If we make this a 2, it will play it at twice the speed. If we change this to 0.5, it will play it at half the speed. So let's speed it up first. Let's set this to 2. Okay, so now when I actually go back to beginning of this segment and hit play.
And one of the things that I discovered about myself,
you can see that the video is playing fast and then it stops.
Years, I was really playing it,
but the audio is still going.
Too safe.
Well, that's because it only takes half as much time to get through all the frames. So what we need to do is we're going to have to actually adjust the width of or the length of our strips. But we'll do that after we have made the adjustment to the audio. So we've actually adjusted the video and sped it up to 2 times. And we want to do the same thing to our audio. But the thing about Blender is that it doesn't really like it when you change the pitch or speed of the playback of the audio strip when you just cut it. You need to import a complete audio strip that you can manipulate so they can stay in sync. So let me just show you that. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that we hit our page up and page down buttons. Now when you hit your page up and page down buttons, what it's going to do is it's going to jump to the beginning and ending of segments. I'm just hitting page up, page down, back and forth. So bring it to the beginning of the segment, and we're going to now hover our mouse over the timeline, and we're going to hit our S button. And what that does is that's a shortcut to say set our start frame to begin at the beginning of this segment. And then we're going to hit our page up button and put our mouse over the timeline and hit the E button, and that tells Blender that we want to set our end frame to the end of that segment. Now, as you guys know, Blender, whenever you hit any of these buttons, it only animates the frame range. So what it's going to do is we're going to click the audio button here, and what Blender is going to do is just render this audio segment to its own file. So let's just do that. Let's hit the audio button, and it's going to offer us an option to save it as a container of WAV, AUG, MP3, whatever. Put it to WAVE and name the file appropriately and hit mix down. Okay, Now, make sure that you guys actually page down and bring it to the beginning of this segment right here. And we're going to right-click on the audio strip and hit delete, because we don't need this original audio strip anymore. We want to import the one we just made. So go to the Add menu, and we're going to go to Sound, and find the file that you just exported, intro.wav for me. And you can see now, if I play this back, let's hear what it sounds like.
And one of the things that I discovered about
so it plays the audio just like it was before. It's still out of sync because we haven't changed the speed.
Really,
so now all we have to do is right-click on the audio strip, scroll down, and there's this option called pitch. Now, we sped up this video strip using our speed control strip to 2 times the speed. So what do you think we should set our pitch to? 2. So let's actually now go back to the beginning of this and hit play.
And one of the things that I discovered about myself was that for many years,
perfect
I was
sync.
Really playing it a little bit too safe.
But look, it's done. So we don't want our strips to be too long. So what do we need to do? Well, you can actually just find the last moving frame of our video. What I'm doing is I'm hitting my arrow keys and going frame by frame, hitting my left arrow key to go back. And I'm going to look and see where the last moving frame is, or the last frame that I hear something on. And it's approximately there. Then I'm going to right click on the handle of this audio strip, hold shift, and I'm going to go down to the original video strip down here, because the speed control strip's length is actually controlled by the original strip. And I'm going to hold my shift button down and I'm going to hit the right handle of this strip, and now they've both been selected. So here's a trick for getting it to go to the green line. If you go to the strip menu and you select snap strips, it will jump whatever you selected to that line. So now all we have to do is we can right click and shift and grab both of these, hit the G button, and drag it over top here, and it will begin at the next frame. So let's actually play this back and see how it looks when we speed everything up.
And one of the things that I discovered about myself was that for many years, I was really playing it a little bit too safe.
Perfect. So what do you think we need to do if we want to slow everything down? Well, we've already exported our audio strip and imported it, so we don't have to do that again. We can actually just go to the audio strip and we can set it to 0.5, and we can go to our speed control strip, right click on that, and we can set this to the actual multiply speed to 0.5, and that will make it half the speed. Now here's the problem you're gonna have now. It needs to actually have more strip space to actually play out, because now that it's playing at half the speed, it's going to take twice as long for it to finish. So we need to make sure that we actually, instead of shrink our strips, we have to give them more space. So let's right-click, shift, or group select these strips over here, and just move them over so we can give ourselves some space. And we're going to right-click on the handle of only the video strip, not the audio strip. So let's right-click on this right handle of the video strip. The reason why we're not doing the audio strip, by the way, is because there's a glitch. It will only let you actually stretch out the video strip, but there's a workaround. So let's hit our G button now, and we're going to stretch this out. And let's just bring our green line over, and let's look for where the ending is located at. So where's the last moving frame? You can either drag over by clicking and holding your left mouse button, or you can use your arrow keys and just tap until you see the last moving frame. So it's right about there. So what I'm going to do now is I've already got this right handle selected. I'm going to snap it by going to strip, snap strips. And then here's the thing. I'm going to right click on this video strip and look at the length over here. It's 482. And we're going to right click on our audio strip and we're just going to set it to the exact same length, 482, enter. Now, you'll notice that I didn't actually drag the right handle, and the reason why is that there is some sort of lock on the handle that will not let you actually stretch it past a certain point. I don't know if that's a feature or a glitch of the audio strip, but the workaround is to type it in over here in the length section. So now we can just grab our audio and video strips over here, hit the G button, and drag them over top till it turns red, and we'll place it right at the next frame. And because we want to play this back, I have the frame range set to only this small section. I'm going to actually change the actual ending frame to be here by hovering my mouse over here and hitting the E key. And we're going to now play this and see what this is like.
And one of the things that I discovered about myself was that for many years I was really playing it a little bit too safe.
So you can see that works absolutely perfectly. So that's how you speed up and slow down audio and video in the Blender program. I'll see you guys in the next video.